presented by Kia.
Hello, everybody. Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Great to have you with us on 2K Sports. Tonight, it's the Houston Rockets as they'll be playing against the Oklahoma City Thunder. And for Oklahoma City, well, these are the games that challenge you. They'll have their work cut out for them, but they believe they can come away with a win. And the Thunder are now in the Billy Donovan era of their franchise. The former college coach was their pick to take them to where they want to be. Kenny, what does Coach Donovan bring to the table?
Well, even though this is his formidable years in the NBA, just forming what he's going to be, he is a veteran coach. He's been coaching all of his life. I've known him since he was a young kid in Rockville Center, where he was shooting up balls for St. Agnes High School, and we were killing him at Archbishop Molloy. But
yeah, the Thunder is the road team for today's Western Conference matchup. We've got some terrific NBA action in store for you today. This is Kevin Harlan, and by my side, Greg Anthony and Brent Beer. And from the sideline, David Aldridge. After this game, the Rockets head back out on the road. An excellent season underway. We've seen a lot of good basketball so far from these guys.
This is a special matchup. I mean, we got here tonight two rival franchises, a lot of history between the two, yeah, and some bad blood. So let's just see how all this adds up in terms of drama.
Well, this game is like camping, intense. These teams are so highly competitive with one another, it's scary.
Before the action gets going here, let's go to David Aldridge, who spoke with Mike D'Antoni. David, what's the news?
Well, guys, he has an admiration for what he called the intelligent, efficient offense played by today's opponent. He told me that the thing about this team is that they are so good at identifying the weak spots in an opponent, and they come at you in multiple ways depending on where those weak spots are. He said, we've got to be ready for everything. Pretty tall order, guys.
Okay, David, thanks. And this is where you start to see the wear and tear of the season tickets toll, Brent. Players start getting tired legs and little injuries begin to crop up.
And this is where opportunities for guys who are a little bit deeper on the bench may crop up. And so the coach's job is to make sure that their confidence is there, that they're ready to go. And when called upon as a player, you're ready to deliver.
That's a good answer. It'll be the Thunder off the tip. All fueled up and ready to go. Brought to you by Gatorade. Let's check out who's on the floor. So for Oklahoma City right now, Westbrook and Robertson are the backcourt pair. Nick Collison out there with Steven Adams. And it's Grant in at the three spot. Oklahoma City on D. Defeated by the Hornets in their last game. They'll try to put that one behind them.
And that was a game where you just sensed that they would get it going and somehow be able to come out with the victory, but just not in the cards on that night.
No, in the end, not even close to being in the cards. Maybe there was some hope for them early on, but by the fourth quarter, people filed out.
Now, here's Grant. Oklahoma City moving it around. Westbrook can't get it to go. Harden outside. Anderson the screen. Three-pointer. And James Harden, good for three. Harden's got the first bucket of the night, a three-pointer for the Rockets. Rockets on defense. Their last encounter was in Oklahoma City, where they were able to handle the Thunder.
Yeah, and they really squeaked out a close one in that last matchup. Came down to just a few turnovers that gave them the margin of victory.
Well, he's an NBA scoring champion. Westbrook sure has improved his entire offensive repertoire since his days in Westwood. So perfect to see Russell Westbrook playing for the Thunder because he himself is a force of nature. A couple of seasons ago, he had three knee surgeries in less than 1 year. And everyone was worried he might lose some of that explosiveness. Are you sure that's not a bionic knee he's got in there?
Sabonis, he's checked in for Oklahoma City. Second free throw, no good. And you know, Westbrook, Brent, undaunted by the knee surgeries, and up until that collision with Patrick Beverley, he had never missed a game. High school, college at UCLA, never.
No, and he never missed one of your broadcasts either, Kevin. You remember in 2015, you got kneed in the face and had to have surgery to repair that cheekbone. So he wore that mask in his return, and then he reeled off that amazing string of triple-doubles. I'm not sure he's human. Can we check his blood type?
Now, here's Grant. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. Rocket 6, Roberson, and it's off from three-point range. Houston's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Ariza has the open look. Drains it from beyond the arc. Ariza's got himself on the board with 3 there. For the Houston Rockets, they come in off a good outing against the Washington Wizards.
They drew a lot of fouls in that game, guys, and that was the one area that really stood out when you watched them.
And it wasn't just the points that they got at the line that helped their cause. It was the foul trouble on the other side that went along with it. Several players stranded on the bench for long stretches, and the coach having to re-strategize.
Now Beverly, after Westbrook's missed three. Anderson outside. Beverly against Westbrook. And Beverly gets to Ariza. Houston needs to get a shot. Releases. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. Here's a look at the teams that have been dominant offensively over the course of the past month. The Rockets, number one.
I just love their offensive flow lately. I mean, this is a dominant team offensively because of that rhythm and pace.
And in this first quarter, about 3 minutes played. Westbrook dishes to Roberson. The pass to Sabonis. The putback. And that one is off. And it's Houston the other way. Ariza outside. He kicks to Harden. They set the pick. And it's Beverly atop the key. Shoots it. Houston gets it back. A second chance effort. And it's laid up and in by Anderson. Anderson's got his first 2 points of the night.
Well, Anderson has impeccable timing and gets inside to grab the old rebound there, really exerting some energy on the glass.
Adams, the pass to Westbrook. The 11-footer, that one goes. Count it.
You see how difficult he makes it on anyone that's going to try to guard him. Just an offensive, dominant player. Come on, Logan, let's go.
Harden outside. Down low, here's Harrell, and that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
It really does make the game easy for your teammates when you can lead them to the rim that well with a pass.
Houston shooting their first free throw of the night here.
And as a team, really just middle of the pack in terms of their percentage from the line at about 76.
Thunder trailing by 8. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Westbrook kicks to Roberson. That's good, and so Westbrook comes up with the assist.
And that's just not something Russell came in doing, being a playmaker. But what we're seeing out of Westbrook now, great vision.
Al Harden. A 23-point game for him in the win against Washington.
Yeah, and it seemed like he spent about half the game shooting free throws. Credit him for really taking it to the defense.
Now, here's Westbrook trailing by 5. He feeds it to Roberson. Screened by Adams. Roberson dishes to Grant. Shot clock at 6. And count the basket. He was fouled, and he's going to the line for one more.
How about the concentration? He gets hit, but stays with the play and gets the finish.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
Not the best statistic for him in terms of his performance at the line. Very low numbers.
And that one misses.
And when you look at the Rockets, I mean, plenty of offense. But last year, there was a huge drop-off defensively. And given this team's lofty goals, that really flies right in the face of that old adage, defense wins championships.
Now, here is Harden. He's averaging just around 28.5 points a game. So many offensive skills in his toolkit.
Outstanding start from three-point range. Their shooters are on fire.
Here's Roberson after the Rockets pick up three. A baseline J makes a big height bounce and goes in. Westbrook's got five. And talking about how the Rockets are structured, they do have some players on the roster, Greg, who can play defense. It's a wonder they've been so bad at that end.
I mean, the problem with defense, though, Kevin, is that it takes all five guys to buy in. You have to have a level of trust on the floor, and that happens for the Rockets only once in a while, which is why they give up an insane number of points to their opponents.
And it's going to be a three-second call. Just a moment to look back at how things were last season for this team as we look at the shot breakdown for the Thunder.
It seems like they found a nice middle ground here. There's some long range, some inside the arc. That kind of offensive versatility makes it really tough for a team to defend.
Rockets leading by four. Harden with it. Anderson the screen. Harden the pass to Harrell. And the Thunder from 2011 to 2014 made the Western Conference Finals twice, as well as the NBA Finals, while still one of the youngest teams in the league. They had, Greg, all the makings of a dynasty.
You felt like they were destined to win a championship and maybe multiple ones. Now you're not so sure. It's a tough business, and being very good often isn't good enough.
First one falls for. Good on the second, so he makes them both. But Brent, we all know that you come from a huge basketball family. Your dad, Rick, leading the way, and in the Hall of Fame, and your brothers all played at various levels. What was it like coming up in a basketball-centric household?
Well, first of all, thanks for the underhanded compliment there. You got that, Kevin?
Yeah.
Sorry about that.
Free throws,
that.
Yes. I got it.
It was a lot of fun. Having two older brothers and one younger was very, very competitive. So maybe some of the sapling from the fruits of that tree dripped into us in regards to playing the game. And just was around it. So it felt very natural to be in a locker room, to be on a gym floor, and then eventually push the potential to see where you could get.
And some pretty good discussions around the family dinner table, I'm sure, on the game.
Some decent ones, but Kevin, we played a lot more wiffle ball, soccer, Nerf football than basketball, and most of those games never ever got to the ending. Too much fighting. Too much
fighting. Some bloody lips.
And a chance here to look at the numbers for Trevor Ariza. He's putting up about 12 points a game, just over two steals and five rebounds. And he's really been pulling his weight. He's had a hand in some big plays here recently.
Thunder trailing by six. And Roberson kicks to Westbrook. They set the pick. Grant outside. Dishes to Westbrook. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. Every year they'll always put out an NBA survey of who is the toughest to guard. No surprise that Russell Westbrook is almost always at the top of the list in those surveys. He just, Greg, strikes fear in opposing defenders.
And Kevin, it's a result of several factors in terms of why he tops that list. He has the game and the body to punish you for all four quarters, and he never lets up in his intensity. And also a knack for putting players who are caught sleeping on posters. It is both physically and mentally draining guarding a guy like Westbrook.
Houston making a switch here. Gordon's checked in. And so Westbrook makes them both. Rockets leading by four. Here is Harden. Five on the clock. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
And already they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backboard.
Grant, right side. Pass to Sabonis. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. That one is on a reason.
You see Billy Donovan out there on the sidelines, and he can't help but to think of all the success he's had as a coach already. Back-to-back titles in college, essentially built that Florida basketball program into a powerhouse. He's hoping that he can bring some of that success translated to the NBA and get himself in title contending position.
And for Billy Donovan, I think that's one of the bigger reasons why he made the jump from college to the pros, Brent. He had nothing left to prove.
Well, one of the reasons why he decided to leave Florida as well, Kevin, was the fact that he really enjoyed the culture of what it is that Oklahoma City represented. There's no reason for Billy Donovan to leave that university unless he felt like the opportunity in front of him had a lot of boxes checked, and OKC did that.
Houston's gone 3-7 from three-point range in the first quarter. They set the pick. In the corner, it's Gordon. Good, it's Harden with the assist that time. Harden's got three assists in the game.
Ooh, that three-pointer right there hurts. The former Indiana Hoosier really can bury those threes in bunches.
And so here is Oklahoma City, trailing by five. Here's Westbrook. Almost, but it rolls out.
That's just terrific court awareness there. The defense knew it was coming and just totally suffocated him.
Gordon kicks to Harden. Back to Gordon. And again, it's the Rockets from deep.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
Here's Kristen. Up top, Kanter. Pass to Kristen. And stolen by Gordon. There's the triple. And another three for Houston.
Their third three-pointer in a row.
Under trailing by 11. There's the pass to Abrines. Back to Westbrook. Stolen by Harden. Now in transition is Brewer. Here we go. And here we go. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two.
Well, Eric Gordon is always a threat as a two-guard to score. However, the defense gets a little too physical with him there, which is why he gets to the free throw line. Well, Eric Gordon coming off that big contract, which ended last season, injuries have just plagued his entire career, still trying to find a season where he can play all 82 games.
That free throw good from Eric Gordon. And Eric Gordon, a good outside shooter. Not quite as explosive as he once was, though, getting to the rim.
Yeah, I agree with you there, Kevin. He's lost a little bit of that burst. Of course, at 6'4", he gives up a little bit of height at the shooting guard position, but still effective in scoring the ball.
And the Thunder making a switch here. Burns checked in. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. And so here is Oklahoma City. It's a 13-point game. Back to Westbrook. There's the dish to LaVerne. It's amazing to watch these NBA athletes competing every day. You and I get the lucky seat right there in front, midcourt, such size, such athleticism. It's intimidating. Who are the most intimidating players, you think, in the game today?
If you go to Detroit and you want to match up with number zero there, and Andre Drummond,
look out.
You're in for a long night.
Harness yourself in.
The way that he can patrol the middle, Kevin, and the way he's relentless at coming at the offensive glass and the defensive glass all game long, I'm really interested in the development of Andre Drummond as the centerpiece, figuratively and literally, for the Detroit Pistons. Hmm.
So he hits one of two from the stripe. Rockets leading by 12. Harden dishes to Nene. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time.
and good passing setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Time called here, the Thunder decide to talk it over.
Check out stats for Harden. Over the last month, he has been spectacular. First in assists, fourth in scoring, and don't forget, top 20 in the league in rebounds per game. He's got a great nose for the ball.
Offside Westbrook. To Kristen, and LaVern kicks to Cantor, and here's Westbrook from the arc. That ball is in the basket. Now he's shot six and made three of them.
This guy whose mindset just never changes, even when they're losing, he's always going to be aggressive.
Westbrook against Harden, back to Nene, stolen by Cantor. Passes it to Kristen. Gordon with the defensive effort.
And they've come out with a take no prisoners approach on the glass here tonight, guys.
Harden against Cantor. Harden the pass to Gordon. He dishes it to Nene. Walking with legends here, guys. A look at some outstanding seasons, decades apart, averaging a triple-double in each game over the course of an entire NBA season. Oscar Robertson's 1961-62 season was something to marvel at. And now in our current era, a special player making his own mark on the NBA with the tremendous play he's been showing us all season long.
And that's still one of the most hallowed achievements in NBA history. I mean, we're talking about the Big O averaging a triple-double over the course of an entire season. I mean, to think we have another player with a shot to do that, it really speaks to the one-of-a-kind season he's having. This is the stuff of legends.
And he can't get the second one to drop either. Coming up empty that time. And just thinking about the way Cantor's career has gone, a lot of high expectations early, Brent, and a starting job after he moved teams.
And I think that might be a key for Cantor in the role of being a scoring big man off the bench. Really can play to his strength, and he can take advantage of another team's second unit, maybe not ready or equipped to handle what he brings to the table offensively.
And so it's Oklahoma City with it. They trail by 11. For Oklahoma City, they have gone 6 of 9 at the line.
Not really where you'd like to be as a team in terms of free throw shooting, just about 73%.
Two shots.
And the first one drops.
Surveying the Thunder roster here, and a lot of the players on it were their own draft picks. They've done a great job of identifying some talent late in rounds in the draft. Found a good amount of rotation players even when they were going deep into the playoffs.
And for the Thunder and their draft success, Brent, it's so important as they aren't usually big players in free agency.
Well, that's a tip of the cap you have to give to their general manager to continue to seek out players that are going to complement the team. Just invaluable.
Dropping bombs. How many more threes are we going to see from him tonight?
Well, some of that is up to the defense. Give him any space on the perimeter, he's going to turn the lights out.
Tries a three. It's rebounded by Houston. On the wing, Gruen. The three. Laverne grabs the miss. Thunder trailing by 12. To the inside. Stolen by Harden. 46 seconds left to play here in the first. Kicks it to Nene. Here's Gordon. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Yeah, the defender all over him.
On the night, he's gone 2 for 2 at the stripe.
Shooting for Houston, Aaron Gordon. Taking 2 shots.
Now, gentlemen, 2 shots. Move shots.
That free throw good from Gordon.
Yeah, you just have to be more disciplined. I mean, too many fouls and free throw attempts for the opponent.
Daniels, he's checked in for Brewer. Both free throws good from Eric Gordon. There's 37 seconds left to play in the first quarter. And that one's good, Kristen.
And he placed that pass out in front of him and let him just run into it in rhythm.
Houston leading by 12. Harden dishes to Decker. There's the pick. Here's the floater. Got a piece of it.
Excellent anticipation from Laverne with the block. He constantly sends back shots with some velocity.
Here's Kristen. Back to Westbrook. And no good trying to get that one. Domination in the first quarter. It's been pretty lopsided. Rockets lead by 12. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. And certainly an intriguing matchup tonight. Let's hear from Trevor Ariza on his team's mentality coming in.
You're playing against a team that is very scrappy. You know, they want to win as well. You got to come ready to play. You got to be ready for everything, and you got to be ready to claw to get this win tonight.
Ariza might as well be describing his own game. Scrappy, ready to play, ready for anything, ready to claw to get that win.
Yeah, and he's been that kind of all-out guy going all the way back to his days at UCLA. When you combine that with his talent, he's a guy who, no matter where he's been, his teammates rave about him.
And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And for the Rockets here, they've been putting on a show, guys.
I tell you what, the scoring has come in threes for the most part here so far.
No kidding. Found that range. Now they can't stop pulling the trigger.
They've got Trevor Ariza. McDaniels is out there with Patrick Beverly. Then there's Ryan Anderson. And it's Harrell in at the center position. So that's who's on the floor for the Rockets. And it's the Rockets with the ball after Enes Kanter's miss. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line. Sabonis, he's checked in for the Thunder. Brent, they say the elite big man in the middle is a dying breed. What do you think? Any truth to that?
How about the birth of the new big man?
Oh, I would say so, too.
I just don't like to be so pessimistic about what it is that we used to see.
You see cycles, right?
Absolutely. So I'm more of one of those guys' glasses half full. So let's celebrate the versatility, the mobility, and the incredible talent of the young players at their size being able to be as effective as they are in the NBA.
And Trevor Ariza is going to pick up a foul here. That'll be his second foul of the game. Rockets on defense. They lead by the biggest margin of the game, 15 points. Screen by Adams. And Roberson kicks to Adams. That one's off. He starts the game with a miss.
No, if you're going to go set a pick, you really have to be committed to it. He simply did not do a good enough job to get his teammate open.
They set the screen. Here's McDaniels, and he comes off the screen and slams it through.
And that's such solid, fundamental basketball on display right there, guys.
You talk about it all the time, Greg. Yeah, great use of the pick to set up a dunk.
Well, that's a play that only works by practicing over and over and having a great rhythm with your teammate. You could see the timing there.
Now, here's Ariza. The feed now to Anderson. Back to Ariza. And it's Ariza finishing it off.
Kevin, is there another player out there capable of moves as stunning as that?
A handful at the most. He is an elite company. And that last replay courtesy of Kia. Here's Grant following the score by Houston. Here's Kristen. Pass to Sabonis. They need this. Ariza with the rebound. Feeds it to McDaniels. Anderson outside from beyond the arc. They get the rebound. And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. Count it. That's 10 points for Montrezl Harrell.
They have got to box out better than that. That putback's just another example of what a difference there's been between these two teams.
Just don't want to see fundamental errors like that. One of the reasons they're so far behind.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Alder.
Well, Kevin, we know that the Thunder hired Billy Donovan as its new head coach. In his 2 decades at the University of Florida, he led them to 2 national titles with players like Al Horford and Joakim Noah. A defensive-minded coach, he's developed into a great offensive mind. Fellas, that's what he's trying to bring to OKC, moving the floor, as he calls it, creating space for their great scorers to operate.
Ball movement, player movement, that's where the league is going, D.A., thanks. See a chart here for the shooting performance so far.
And it's really been a tremendous night. He's been efficient. He's been a major driving force in this offense. And it's no small task to try to slow him down. Once he gets rolling, like we've seen in this game so far, watch out.
And we're now a little over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. And Roberson kicks to Kristen. Sabonis, it's deflected.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And Harrell slams it in.
Incredible spring off the floor there for a power forward, and he needs that as an undersized big.
And it's the Thunder with the ball. The Rockets making the shot to stop the drought. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot. With the break in the action, let's go to the 2K leaderboard. These teams have been dialed in defensively this month. In third, the Rockets.
What a month they've had defensively. I mean, they've really gotten after it on that end of the floor.
For Oklahoma City, they have attempted 11 free throws today and converted 8 of them. And he makes the first. And the Rockets making a change here. Brewer's checked in. That one misses. Look at the elite players in the NBA. A much more tight-knit bunch than maybe in decades past, Brent. Not as much animosity as we used to see between players on different teams. Do you agree with that? And maybe more importantly, why is it different now than it was then?
We always talk about the AAU programs and what it is that these elite players are offered up in terms of their early stages of development, Kevin. When you're in sixth grade and you know somebody from D.C. is friends with somebody in Oakland because they get to see one another throughout the course of the AAU programs over the summer and where these tournaments are held, it's understandable that the elite players in the NBA are going to have relationships that exist before they get there. So I don't have any problem with it whatsoever.
Anderson passes to Beverly. Here's the screen. Back to Anderson. Takes a three. And again, it's the Rockets from deep.
Anderson always looking to get up a three-point shot. He had some space there and took advantage.
The Thunder have gotten off to a rough start here in the second quarter. 0-for-5. And the pass to Sabonis. Grant kicks to Adams. Nice shot from 10 feet out.
Fantastic awareness out on the floor. That's a textbook assist.
Houston's gone 2-of-4 from three-point range so far in the second quarter. Ariza outside. Anderson the screen. Grant against Ariza.
That is a terrible foul to commit. He now has two, and he's going to have to play more conservative from now on.
And Brewer kicks to Beverly. Charity stripe shot. He's off on that one. And it's Oklahoma City the other way. They'll host the Denver Nuggets after this one. That game will be a quick pit stop before hitting the road again. Here's Kristen. Screened by Adams. And Kristen kicks to Roberson. They get it back. Adams dishes to Roberson. Pass to Kristen. Grant outside. Here's Kristen, defended by Beverly. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Beverly. And watching Adams go to work out there, he is a bit of an old school big man in the sense that Brent Hill, he'll throw his weight around and look to intimidate the other team.
Yeah, Adams willing to take on that role, take the punches and take the hits for the rest of his team. And it goes along with his great defensive instincts, I think. His activity down low, certainly a big help for this team's defense.
And Andre Roberson is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul. Rockets have gone 7-for-10 here in the second quarter. They'd like to keep up that nice pace. There's a good screen. Beverly, the pass to Harrell. Anderson wide open. A three-pointer off the mark. Oklahoma City's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. And Kristen kicks to Adams. To the middle. Here's Sabonis. Finally gets one to fall. He's now 1-for-5 with his first make.
Oh, I love that dish down low.
And here's Beverly. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Anderson kicks to Brewer. Nailed from three-point land.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Screen by Grant. Here's Kristen. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so we will go to the line. A three-point play chance here. Houston with a big group substitution here. Nene, he's checked in for Harrell. Decker comes in for Ryan Anderson. Eric Gordon, he's checked in for Trevor Ariza. And it's Harden in for Patrick Beverly. Rockets have gone 8-of-13 in the second quarter, well above the 50% mark from the field. Outside Gordon. He kicks it to Harden. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. They get Russell Westbrook.
You know, the thing about James Harden, though, there's really no perfect way
to defend him. I mean, he can torch you from deep, drives the lane as well as anybody, especially when he's looking to create contact. And in many ways, your best defense against him is a good offense. You try to match some of his points by scoring on the other end. Well documented that maybe defense not his strength, but, you know, that's an area where if you want to have success, you're going to have to do a good job on that end.
Enes Kanter's checked in for Sabonis. And he sinks the second. And thinking about ways to stop Harden, part of the problem is that he's really built like no other player out there.
Physically, he's got that barrel of a body, the long arms, and just enough quickness to blow by you. He's elusive yet always looking for contact, which is why he lives at the free throw line.
Now here's Westbrook. He had a 33-point outing in their last game against Charlotte. That one's in, only his fourth make against 9 total shots.
Well, that's some great concentration there from Westbrook. Does a great job finishing off inside, even with the hand in his face.
Here's Gordon, coming off 31 points last game. Off the pick. Kicks it out to Harden. He feeds it to Gordon. Nene, the screen. Over in the corner, Decker. Another miss by Houston. Oklahoma City's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. Another miss by Westbrook.
And those are the shots that you expect him to make. You've seen it before, and so far, just not on his A game tonight.
Decker with it. LaVerne on him. Brewer's shot is off.
Yeah, he is struggling mightily, but his teammates in this one have picked him up.
Another miss by Westbrook.
I think the defense was surprised that he did not knock that down. Clear defensive breakdown there, guys. Should have made him pay.
Difficult situation for Oklahoma City. Passes it to Kristen. Kanter, high post. Oklahoma City moving it around. There's a screen by Kanter. And he lays it straight in. Kanter's got his first basket of the night.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
Nene setting the pick for Harden. The 11-footer, that one drops for him. Harden's got 6 points.
And he could be the guy to put this game out of reach.
Yep, wanted to put another nail in the coffin and using those hands as a hammer.
Now, here's LaVerne. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game. Bucket is good.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Rockets leading by 21. Outside, Gordon. Dishes to Hart. Kicks it to Decker. The feed now to Brewer. Rocket 6. Here's Harden on the wing. He's covered by Westbrook. Harden's shot is off.
Terrific defense. They definitely read the scouting report on this guy and could not have played him more perfectly there.
Westbrook double team. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
Well, what you have to like about Enes Kanter, defense aside, is that he's an efficient scorer. He's got great instincts to offensive rebound and be in position for somebody to feed him the ball on the inside.
For Oklahoma City, they have made 10 of their 14 tries at the free throw line in the game. And for Kanter, his play is what everyone envisioned for him when he was taken 3rd overall back in that 2011 draft.
Well, the hopes for every general manager looking at Kanter was that he'd be a great low post scorer, and that's where he's shown most of his prowess, there and at the offensive glass, where he just simply swallows everything up and puts it back in the basket.
And Kanter drops them both.
Such a big guy, Kanter, but also incredibly lean. At the NBA Combine, for instance, he tested out at 6% body fat, an extraordinarily low number for a man of his size.
Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Fearless, despite the size mismatch, took it right to him.
And for all the scoring, Greg, that James Harden gives you, he's also one of the top playmakers in the NBA.
You know, and even coming out of college, Kevin, a lot of scouts felt Harden could play the point. I mean, that's one of the reasons why this guy is going to consistently be in the MVP conversation.
Here's Kristen. 6 points for him. Pass to Abrines. The dish to Westbrook. Goes up at the stripe. That's in for his fifth field goal of the game. Makes him 5 for 12 so far.
Well, he's got no problem getting to that spot on the floor. Westbrook now looks more confident in those kind of results.
McDaniels dishes to Decker. Back to Harden. McDaniels kicks to Nene. Knocks down the 10-footer. Thunder have gone 7-16, shooting just under 50% here in the second quarter. Feeds to Laverne. Now the pass to Abrines. He dishes it to Westbrook. And it's Westbrook again missing.
+8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Nene, the screen. Gordon outside. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Cantor's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Expanding his range. It's rebounded by Houston.
Yeah, we're chipping some orange paint off the rim here, guys. He must be more patient on offense and trying to find ways to penetrate inside and get closer to the rim.
Now, here's Decker. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. And Laverne gets the whistle that time. So that will be his second foul of the game. We're in the bonus, and we'll go to the line to shoot 2. For Houston, they have shot 10 of 13 from the free throw line.
Shooting 2.
That free throw good from Decker, and the Thunder making a switch here. Robertson's checked in. Both good from the line that time. Here's Westbrook. 14 points for him. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Pass to Laverne. He kicks to Robertson. Shoots the 3. And Russell Westbrook good for 3. Westbrook's got 7 points for the quarter.
And no hesitation with Westbrook being challenged on that shot. That's just how much confidence he has in his game.
Harden outside. The teardrop falls in. Harden's got 11 points.
He knew what he wanted to do all along. The teardrop.
And so a pretty lopsided game through the first half. Rockets on top, running away with it. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Coach Billy Donovan, you faced an aggressive team in that first half. How concerned are you by their success against your defense?
Well, they've done a very, very good job, I think, attacking the paint early. Offensive rebounds, some of those turnovers right there led out to some fast breaks. So we just got to stay with it and try to keep our energy up.
We'll see if you can keep that flow going in the second half. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, for that interview. And we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And we hope you've enjoyed our first half of action. I'm Ernie Johnson welcoming you back. Shaquille O'Neal is right there. Kenny the Jet Smith is right there. And this here is the halftime report. Eric Gordon taking care of business in this one. He had 16 points, 2 rebounds, and 1 steal. Kenny, what'd you think about the Rockets?
How good are these guys on the fast break? They're pushing the ball, finding the open man, finishing strong. They're at a breakneck pace, and if they can maintain this level of intensity in the second half, blowout city.
And big fella, let's get your thoughts on the Thunder.
Well, first of all, as cold as they've been from the floor, I can't say I'm surprised by the score. You cannot shoot the ball that poorly and expect to be in the game, Ernie. They need better ball movement. If their offense stays this stagnant, they could forget about a comeback.
And that's it for halftime, as the second half is just about to get underway. See you after the game.
Day turning tonight here in the Southwest. We're in Houston. Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back, everyone, to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down in the third and fourth quarters. Rockets leading by 23. So for Oklahoma City right now, Westbrook and Robertson are the backcourt pair. Adams is out there with Nick Collison, and it's Grant in at the three. Now here's Ariza on the wing. Harden tries from 10. Harden missing again. The Thunder shooting 39% from the floor, not their best. And Robertson kicks to Adams. Westbrook against Gordon. Westbrook passes to Adams and stolen by Gordon. He feeds it to Harden. Stolen by Westbrook. Passes it to Roberson. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. Roberson's got the first basket of the third quarter for the Thunder. And for Houston, they're shooting it up around 51%. They're getting good looks. Harden kicks to Gordon. Here's Harrell, and fouled as he went up to the dunk. Good aggressive move, and he'll shoot two.
Clearly a foul.
And this is his fourth trip to the free throw line tonight.
Montrez Harrell at the line for two.
He misses the free throw. Patrick Beverley, he's checked in for the Rockets. So he can't get either to fall. Thunder trailing by 21. Right side, Westbrook kicks it to Collison. Ball's knocked loose. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Alden.
Well, guys, it seems at times that Russell Westbrook can put up a triple-double at will. But he said, everybody thinks that I care about numbers and things like that, but I really don't. I don't think about who shoots, how many times I shoot. That really doesn't matter to me. I just like to win. All that matters is if we win. Kevin?
XDA, one of the most competitive players in the NBA.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts. And they start the second half with three straight misses.
That one falls. 2 minutes into the second half of play now. Now here's Harden. 11 points in the game. Anderson the screen. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
Really aggressive play there, taking it to the rack against the big fella.
Well, even the dentist would tell you that's a sweet move for that lay-in. And yeah, you gotta love his tenacity.
Sabonis, he's checked in for Oklahoma City. Free throw drops for Harden. Well, Thunder have gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. And Roberson kicks to Westbrook. had enough on that one as it misses.
Now that's terrific defense at the rim. Got right in his path.
All instinctual because he knows where he needs to go and then forced the opponent to do something about it.
Yeah, the defender all over him.
Shooting for Houston, Montrezl Harrell at the line for two.
He's off on the first. Ennis Kanter's checked in for Adams. And the second free throw, good. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. Outside Westbrook. Inside. Here's Kanter. Here's Roberson. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
Well, there's no doubt he's known for defense and rebounding, but you have to admire the work Roberson has put in improving his shooting stroke. Well, watch Roberson play and you'll see why it is that he's respected amongst his teammates. Great length with his arms, can guard the 1-4 position, and blends size and speed. The only thing that you'd like to see is him improve his consistency from the 3-point line.
That one falls, so he hits both of them. Thinking a bit more about Roberson and his defense, he can do it all from jumping a passing lane to sending a shot into the third row.
Yeah, so really for him, it's all about timing. Very smart in the way he lines up to block shots and a good sense of knowing when to jump in and help off the ball.
Now Kanter. James Harden missing on the three. And Kanter throws it down.
The sheer strength of Kanter really coming through there. Throws it down with intent.
Rockets leading by 19. Anderson the screen. It's Harden with the drive. Anderson dishes to Harrell. And a look here at the shot chart.
And as this chart shows, things just aren't falling for him like they usually do. He isn't ice cold, but nothing is falling his way, and he's become an inefficient source of points for his team.
Tonight, he's gone 5 of 8 from the foul line.
And would love to hear a little more swish and a lot less clang from the charity stripe.
First one falls for him. That one misses, so he goes 1-for-2.
And missing opportunities here to extend that lead at the free throw line this half.
And that one is good.
Oh, nicely done. Finding good opportunities inside. Priority one.
Here is Harden following the score by Oklahoma City. Dishes it to Anderson. Back to Harden. Clock at 6. Beverly against Westbrook. And it's Beverly missing.
He has got a lot of confidence in his game. You have to if you think you can knock one down from there.
Yeah, and let's not get on him too much, but that shot is also a little irresponsible.
Stolen by Beverly. It's 2-on-1. A pull-up, and Harden gets it to go in on the assist by Beverly. 16 points for James Harden.
He's just so efficient, getting his points within the flow of the offense. Great recipe for success.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. And while we can, let's find out a little bit about the shooting guards around the league and which of them have had the most assists over the last 10 games. James Harden, number one.
And with his skill as a distributor, he's probably just as comfortable at the point guard position as he is off the ball. They need him there at times in a pinch.
Well, he never puts himself before his teammates, we know that. And unfortunately, that's not something we can say about all the two guards in the NBA. He inspires a fantastic team-first attitude through the whole squad.
A three-pointer is right on target. Roberson's got 9 points now in just the second half.
There's no doubt that each year he gets a little better and more comfortable from beyond the arc. That helps Roberson stay on the floor for more minutes.
Over in the corner, Beverly. Anderson, a screen on Westbrook. And Beverly kicks to Anderson.
And a former most improved player, Ryan Anderson, led the Pac-10 in scoring back at Cal Berkeley in his sophomore season. Truly a golden bear.
It's his first trip to the line.
And he's at nearly 90% from the free throw line this season, so having a terrific year.
And the first one drops.
And Ryan Anderson loves to get himself to the free throw line. He is a dead-eye shooter from pretty much everywhere on the floor.
And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time. Thunder trailing by 19. Here's Roberson. 12 points for him. Let's it go from 11. And it's James Harden with the rebound. And Ryan Anderson led his high school, Oak Ridge, to a Division II state title.
Well, Ryan Anderson seems to be one of those guys who's just a grinder, not getting tons of national publicity and then bursting on the scene. And that scene happens to be the NBA.
It's blocked. It's going to be out of bounds. The Rockets will retain possession. Long range from the inbound. Anderson can't get that one to fall. Thunder trailing by 19. Defense! 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 Outside Westbrook. Defense! Defense! Cantor sets the pick for Westbrook. Back to Roberson. Defense! Defense! A three-pointer off the mark. And for Houston, they're shooting 47% from the floor. Getting it done. The Rockets with another miss.
You can't fault him for taking the open look, guys. Just didn't go in for him. But, you know, he'll look to shoot that one again.
Sabonis. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
No, I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
These are his 3rd and 4th free throw attempts of the game. Free throw good. Sabonis. Daniels, he's checked in for James Harden. That one is no good. Houston leading by 18. Now Beverly. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Anderson right side. Off the pick. And that's good for 2.
Well, he's a confident player, but his teammates are confident that he's going to make shots like that one there.
Well, Thunder have gone even 5 of 10 on shot attempts in the 3rd. Outside Westbrook. To the paint. Here's Cantor. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. Westbrook's got 6 assists in the game. Rockets shooting an ugly 27% since halftime. Beverly, the pass to McDaniels. Back to Beverly. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a 3-point play.
Terrific effort on that shot. I mean, he's given up a lot of inches in that mismatch.
And that shows once again that craftiness and body positioning can overcome just someone's sheer size.
Catching up on the changes for Houston. Nene comes in for Harrell, and Decker subbed in for Ryan Anderson. And Oklahoma City with a change here, too. Abrines has checked in for Roberson. That's good from Beverly. Thunder trailing by 21. Westbrook dishes to Grant. Canner, high post. Pass to Abrines. Now the feed to Westbrook. Bank shot, no good.
He's not picking his spots out there right now, at least not well. He's forcing low percentage opportunities, and it's no surprise the frustration right there on his face.
And he's made more than his fair share of those today.
Oklahoma City's gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. And Kanter now, top the key. Grant outside. The dish to Westbrook. Six on the shot clock. Westbrook missing again.
Yeah, tough with his shot so far off right now. They're going to have to tap someone else to step up until he finds it.
McDaniels kicks to Ariza. Stripped it away. Abrines the pass to Westbrook. And it's Westbrook again missing.
He just doesn't seem to be himself shooting the ball right now, guys. Just looks a tad bit uneasy, and that's affecting the result.
Now, here's Beverly. Looking at his numbers, he averages a bit over 9 points a game.
At the line, for your Rockets, KJ McDaniels. At the line for two.
No good on the free throw. The Rockets making a switch here. Gordon's checked in. And Oklahoma City also making a switch. Laverne, he's checked in for Sabonis. And he's good on the second. For Oklahoma City, they've gone 6 of 14 since halftime. A little cold from the field. Grant kicks to Westbrook. There's the pass to Abrines. Tries a three, and it's Russell Westbrook with the three. Westbrook's got 20.
Just becoming better and better at the catch and shoot game. If Westbrook ever perfects that part of the offensive end of the floor, look out.
Now here's Beverly. Here's Nene. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
What a play there. The hoop plus the harm.
This is his second trip to the free throw line.
Not the best statistic for him in terms of his performance at the line. Very low numbers.
Steven Adams, he's checked in for Enes Kanter. So here is Oklahoma City. Abrines defended by Gordon. Westbrook passes to Abrines. Got a hand on it. Here's McDaniels outside Gordon. Here's McDaniels. He's covered by Grant. McDaniels dishes to Decker. Down to five on the shot clock. Near the three-point line, it's Gordon. Another miss by Houston.
That was some very intimidating, aggressive defense that really helped alter that shot.
Over to the wing. Screen by Grant. Stolen by Gordon. Feeds it to Decker. Over in the corner, McDaniels. He dishes it to Beverly. Shot clock at 6. 17-foot shot on the way. And there's the foul. It's on Sam Decker. That'll be his second foul of the game.
You know what? Tried to step in and cut him off, but just didn't get there quick enough.
And Oklahoma City making a change here. Collison's out there. Westbrook with it. He's got 20. To the inside. Adams' shot is good.
Well, using his wide frame right there, Adams able to get the position he wants and drops it through.
And here's Beverly. A minute 50 left in the third quarter of the game. McDaniels kicks to Nene. It's hauled in by Adams. Adams has got his third rebound tonight.
You always talk about glue guys and guys that do the little things to help their team. Steven Adams is certainly that for the Oklahoma City Thunder. Not a big presence in the box to score, but when you watch him play with his team, he's willing to sacrifice his body, set hard screens, and be a presence on the interior.
And so it's Houston with it after Oklahoma City gets the three. McDaniels kicks to Gordon. All sorts of time. No good on that one. So the Thunder will take it the other way. Oklahoma City moving the ball around. Grant outside. He kicks it to Westbrook. Fires from 14. Decker with the rebound.
Well, he's the last guy you want to leave open there, but somehow he didn't knock it down.
McDaniels passes to Nene. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. Adams. And so he's picked up his final foul. He will sit for the rest of this game. So it's both teams making substitutions here.
At the line for two.
Free throw good, Nene. Anderson, he's checked in for the Rockets. Harden comes in for McDaniels. And so Nene nails both of them. Thunder trailing by 21. Now, here's Westbrook. He's got 20. Here's Sabonis. And the rebound goes to the Rockets. Nene's got his third rebound on the night. Here's Gordon. And Grant sends it back. Here's Roberson. Pass to Westbrook. Shot from the wing. No good trying to beat the buzzer. And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead, and this one may already have been decided. The Rockets on top, delivering the blowout. And fourth quarter basketball will be coming your way on 2K Sports right after this. Fourth quarter might not come down to the wire, but you never know. Thunder trailing by 21. Harden out there with Gordon. Then it's Trevor Ariza. Then there's Harrell. And it's Anderson in at the four spot. So that's who's on the floor for the Rockets. And the whistle blows as the basket counts and a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up. That's good from Cantor. Now Harden. He feeds it to Anderson. Passes it to Gordon. From the arc. Good for another field goal. Number 5 in the night. 5 for 10 shooting.
And once Eric Gordon receives that pass, he's just rising up. So a natural rhythmic jump shot.
Harden against Westbrook. Sabonis, the pass to Grant. Kicks it to Robertson. They get the rebound. Cantor, and the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
What's up?
Just a positive force right now for these guys, and though his team has fallen a bit short, it's not because of him.
Rockets leading by 18. Harden with it. Dishes it to Harrell. Pass to Anderson. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. And coming into the league, Ryan Anderson had always been described as a happy-go-lucky type. Just a big heart and a kind, big kid. But a couple of years ago, Brent, he endured some tremendous adversity.
Well, you remember 2015 in the early part of January, that scary collision, Kevin, on the court, which ended the year requiring some neck surgery. And anytime you're up around the head area, you got to be really careful with any player in their future. After that lengthy recovery and some off-season training, Ryan Anderson has found his game once again.
And both free throws good for Anderson.
Yeah, sometimes in a game you settle a little bit before settling in, and right now I think he's a big factor in how they're getting to the line. Love to see passes to guys on the move that are on target. They don't break stride.
And so here is Houston following the score by Oklahoma City. He tries for three. Basket number 5 goes in. He's now 5 of 12 from the floor.
Yeah, you would think a coach might have talked to his defense about making the adjustment on him, but right now, he's just lighting him up.
Grant kicks to Westbrook. Beyond the arc. Hits the three-point bomb. Westbrook's got 23 points.
Well, he now has 4 three-pointers this game, guys. 2 in each half. He's really spacing out the floor for his teammates.
The wing, Harden. He's covered by Westbrook, and the foul called on Russell Westbrook. And that'll be his 3rd foul so far. And we're around 2 minutes into the 4th quarter here. Here's Harrell. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up, and 2 shots coming up.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
Shooting for Houston, Montrezl Harrell. 2 shots.
That free throw missing. And he sinks the 2nd. 2nd minute off the clock now in the 4th. Westbrook kicks to Cantor. It's Robertson, top of the key. There's a screen. Screen by Grant. The kick out to Westbrook. 6 to shoot. Another miss by Westbrook.
A good board there, Kevin, but overall they're getting slightly out-rebounded.
Gordon dishes to Ariza. There's the feed to Harrell. Outside Gordon. Hands it from downtown. Gordon's got 22 points.
Well, he is a huge reason why they have this lead.
Outside Westbrook. Unloads from 13. And it's Westbrook again missing. Here's Gordon. It's blocked. Grant the pass to Westbrook. Cantor with a screen on Harden. There's the dish to Robertson. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. Westbrook's got assist number 10 tonight with that last one. Rockets leading by 19. Harden outside. And another three for Houston.
Look, I checked the numbers, guys. We know he is great from out there. He made one in the first half. Now he has one so far in this half. Look out.
And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time. The whistle blowing. A lot of international players coming to the NBA. Brent, the number have reached triple digits. About a quarter of the league now from overseas.
Amazing that NBA scouts and general managers continue to comb the globe to try to find the best available talent. And it still speaks to what it is that those club systems in the European countries are able to do with their younger players.
And I always think of the old coaches would go overseas, hold these camps and get these kids at a very young age and teach them the principles of basketball.
And a lot of coaches, Kevin, are still looking at the fundamental elements of the game. And it seems like the European players are the ones that they always point to that are ahead of where we are here in the States.
He hits the second from the line. Over 3.5 minutes through the final quarter now. The pass to Gordon. They set the pick. Fires the three. Harden's shot is off. Thunder trailing by 21. Feeds to Robertson. Outside Westbrook. Oklahoma City moving it around. Grant outside. He dishes it to Westbrook. Just 5 on the clock. And it's in off the backboard. Westbrook's got 5 points now this quarter.
I'm not sure what's clicked in for Russell Westbrook, but every year he's showing to be a better and better passer and rebounder and a better player overall. That's what being a gym rat has done for him.
Now here's Harden. Left side, Gordon. Harden sets the pick for Gordon. He kicks to Harden. To the middle. Here's Harrell. That's tipped. Expanding his range. And it's Westbrook again missing. Rockets leading by 19 points. Gordon kicks to Harrell. It's in, and he's a very efficient 5 for 6 on the game.
A great pass from Gordon there, leading to the assist.
Thunder have gotten into a pretty good groove, going 6 of 10 here in the final quarter. Westbrook a screen on Harden. Westbrook against Gordon. The 10-footer. Cantor. Right side Westbrook. Over Anderson. And it's Westbrook again missing. Rockets have gone 5 for 9 from the field in the final quarter so far. And Harrell slams it in.
Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Yep, you're right. Finished hard with 2 hands on that stuff. Screen by Grant. Ariza against Westbrook. Pass to Sabonis. Fires from deep. Good. Nice assist from Westbrook.
Wow, something's brewing, guys. The three-pointers just continue to flow.
Ariza with the bucket.
Almost uncontested. I mean, it's nice to be able to add to the lead without having to really work for it.
They're looking like a beaten team at this point, letting him get to the basket with such little resistance.
Here's Cantor. Following the score by Trevor Ariza.
Well, after an impressive first half, he's just not been able to get the room or get anything going here in the second.
Outside Gordon. Lays it up, and despite of the excellent defense at that, Gordon's got 8 points in the quarter.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Here's Roberson. There's a screen by Cantor. And Roberson kicks to Westbrook. Double team on Westbrook. Westbrook missing again.
Can't get anything to drop. I mean, the way he's going, it's probably not something he should try and shoot his way out of.
Can't keep forcing things when you're not in a great rhythm. Move the ball.
Now Westbrook. James Harden missing on the three. Little shot fake there, got the D out of position. And now it's 27 points for Russell Westbrook. Harden outside. He feeds it to Harrell. Some solid defense from Grant. Oklahoma City's gone beyond the arc 7 times here in the fourth and been successful 3 times. No good with the triple.
Boy, I'd love to see him just get a smidge closer to the basket. Once he sees a few shots go in from there, that might open up everything from distance.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys. Here's Westbrook following the score by Houston. Here's Cantor. The rebound by Anderson. Anderson's got rebound number 12 here already in the game. It's Ariza on the wing. Harden gets to Ariza. That doesn't go either for Ariza. The Thunder shooting at 42% in this final quarter. Outside Westbrook. And Westbrook throws it down hard.
Well, the defense respecting the shot right there, and that creates a lane for him to drive right through. That's his game.
And here's Harden. Passes to Gordon. Now here's Harrell. Not a lot of room. Takes a big high bounce and goes in. Harrell's got 9 points here in the second half.
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
There's a screen by Cantor. Kicks it to Roberson. Lets it go from deep. Rebound by Harrell. Harrell's got 6 rebounds here tonight.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Anderson the screen. There's the pick. Ariza with the bucket.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Yep, he's going to kill you coming off of those down screens. As a defender, you have to fight over the top.
Now, here's Westbrook. Grant kicks to Westbrook. The Rockets pull it in. Harrell's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Dishes it to Ariza. Outside Gordon to the left wing. Anderson passes to Harden. Pulls it from 20. And they force the shot clock violation. Great D. Brent, I know you like the NBA D League growing to over 20 teams this season. Every team now will have their own D League affiliate. It makes so much sense on so many levels.
I think it's awesome that we're going to eventually get to 30 teams in the D League so that every coach has the opportunity to develop his players. You're going to have an assistant coaching staff and a head coaching staff at the D League that's using the same exact language that you're going to hear if you move up and get 10 days with the big ball club or eventually sign a contract for the rest of the season. That fluctuation for players and for the franchises is going to be very, very beneficial.
The quality of the player coming up to the D League now has never been better either.
No, he's had some great success stories with D League players coming up and playing some important roles throughout the course of the regular season, but these affiliations, Kevin, directly with the big ball club are going to pay some huge dividends.
Nene kicks to McDaniels. Nene, the screen. Shot off the screen. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City.
And you know, coaches just love players who they can count on to give that effort defensively.
Yeah, he sat in that mid-range area, which can be a no-man's land defensively, but he quickly moved over to contest.
Now, here's Collison. To the middle, takes it up with both hands and rips it down.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for the Rockets.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often, but tonight this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And now on the year, this will take them to 28 wins.
And they put themselves into the driver's seat in regards to the season series with this team. Tonight's win will give them a 2-1 edge with only one left to play. A fantastic show. And what an amazing all-around game it was for Gordon. You can do a lot to change a game other than scoring, and it was his quick hands on the defensive end that put them in the driver's seat.
And so here is Houston, following the score by Oklahoma City. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Brown wide open, he fires. Looks a big height bounce and goes in.
And you can sense the fact that they didn't want to let the fans down here. It's been a fun night to be in the building.
A phenomenal effort level. These guys came in committed to dictating the action.
So we see Houston taking the W here. They won this game going away. They were the better basketball team by far tonight.
And you got to commend this sort of dominance, particularly here at home. It's a great feeling when you play almost a perfect game and to have that crowd be so pumped up.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much. James, congrats on the win. Great crowd tonight, but what made the difference down the stretch?
We just got to play solid defense. Talk to each other, help each other out. Crowd was amazing tonight. You know, it was unbelievable. Like I said, I'm happy for our guys. And, we got a good victory at home.
Big, big win, James. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David. Great job. Thanks so much. And that'll do it, folks. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. And now time to go to Ernie Johnson, who's alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Hey, everybody. Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. It is time now to present our Jordan player of the game, Eric Gordon. He didn't waste any time. The first quarter numbers he put up were frightening and certainly set the table for his team to prosper here tonight.
He hit a little over half of his shots tonight. I thought he showed a lot of patience, he made good decisions, and he had good look. Obviously, it paid off.
Ernie, Kenny, what got into this guy tonight? He was sensational. Easily the MVP of the game. Maybe it was some of that home cooking. Fried chicken, macaroni and cheese, potato salad, iced tea. He was getting a lot of love from the fans, and rightfully so. Seeing him step his game up like that will always get the crowd pumped.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. For Kenny Smith, for Shaquille O'Neal, for Kevin Harlan, and for the entire 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson. I hope you have a wonderful, even beyond wonderful, a spectacular, just great. I mean, see you.
Good night.